they were shut down for so long, and it was so important, I think, to them to finally be heard.
And as a filmmaker, you also had people trying to stop you from proceeding and making the film. So in many ways, it's almost against all odds that you succeeded. Was there ever a time that you started to doubt the whole process of what you were doing and wonder how you would get through it all?
Well, in the very, very beginning when we did start, we had many, many no's, not just from survivors and people that we did reach out to. We had, you know, people who were in fear that something would happen to them or their families. I'm talking even people who were friends of his, people who are in his little black book. You know, we had so many people, you know, say, oh, I never met him. And then you see photos of them elsewhere together. And, you know, people wanted nothing to do with them. So we had many, many hurdles to climb in that respect, because it was very complicated and we were shot down by a number of people. Some of them did come around. That's part of the don't give up. You know, are they really afraid? Are they afraid of him? And then, you know, you would revisit that later, you know, later on, as some people left the door open, or even if they didn't leave the door open after he died, we kind of circled back. And sure enough, because we had done some of the meeting with them and some of the talking with them, they felt we were really in this before everybody else. And we really do care to get that story out. So it was very interesting in that respect.
How concerned were people around you?
You know, it's interesting. My husband, I did take a couple of trips to St. Thomas, which is a stone's throw from Epstein's private island. There's a tracker on your phone, and he couldn't track me one night, and he was very worried. It did get at some points. I wouldn't say I was scared of him. He definitely was aware. I actually knocked on his door several locations and spoke to different people who had worked for him. I would buzz the buzzer that was outside of his gates. And I met his houseman, Renato, several times. And I would leave my car to identify myself. And we were tracking his flight. So we knew he was there.